Hello students, welcome back to the next video tutorial of Bio Inorganic Chemistry. In this video we will discuss the blood coagulation, means the clot formation, or it is also called as coagulation cascade. To get the notification of the next video, please subscribe to the video. I am Dr. Sujata Kasabe from ABASAHEB GARWARE College, Pune. Let us begin with the blood coagulation cascade. The blood is transformed into solid gel at the site of vessel damaged. This reaction occurs in a cascade manner, hence it is called the coagulation cascade. Now let us see the process in detail. There are two pathways for the blood coagulation, namely intrinsic pathway and extrinsic pathway. Let us begin with the first pathway, that is intrinsic pathway. The intrinsic pathway has endogenous activation, which is driven by the endothelial collagen that exposes it to platelets. And extrinsic pathway has the exogenous activation, that is driven by the damaged tissue releases the tissue factor. So the first pathway is the intrinsic pathway. We saw that when the collagen is exposed to the platelets, upon the endothelial damage, the factor 12 gets activated. The activation of the factor 12 is aided by the polyphosphate, which is released by the activated platelets also, and at this point the cascade starts. From here, this activated factor 12 acts upon the inactive factor 11 and activates it. Then this activated factor 11 in turn activate the factor 9 and now finally this activated factor 9 acts on the inactive factor 10 to become active. So now we have finally activated factor 10. But see, this activation of factor 10 is also aided by activated factor 8. Now the question arises here is where this factor comes from and it is active. We'll see in the next part. Here activated factor 10 acts on the factor 2, that is prothrombin, and it converts into thrombin, that is active factor 2. Remember, this active factor 2, that is thrombin, also acts upon the factor 5 which is further essential in the activation of thrombin in next loop. So here we have activated factor 2, that is thrombin. We will stop the first pathway, that is an intrinsic pathway. The reason is that we will see the extrinsic pathway to combine both of these pathways at some points, which is common. Now in the beginning of the video we saw that the extrinsic pathway is exogenous activation, which gets activated due to tissue injury. When there is endothelial damage, the tissue releases the tissue factor, which acts upon factor 7. And makes it active factor 7. And then this factor 7, which is activated, acts directly upon factor 10 and makes it active factor 10. Also, we have seen that the thrombin also activate the factor 8. In this way, here these two pathways merged at factor 10 activation, and now from here the common pathway starts. This thrombin acts on two factors. So the first is inactivated factor 1, that is fibrinogen. This fibrinogen is soluble protein which becomes active after the action of thrombin, that is fibrin 1, which is insoluble protein. And on the other hand, thrombin acts on inactive factor 13 and convert it into active factor 13. Hereafter, finally, these two activated factor, that is factor 1 fibrin and factor 13, forms the cross linked fibrin clots. Where the coagulation process get completed by the formation of blood clots. So student, that is all for the blood coagulation. Thank you for watching the video.